Hi everyone and welcome to my channel. It's Asia Marka here, Lemon Creation. And today I have for you very easy, minimalistic scrapbooking layout featuring Maremi Small Art products. As you can see, I have this beautiful Art Technique paper pad from Marta Łapkowska, and inside there are a lot of different papers with beautiful designs. They are elements to cut out, like the one I'm showing you right now. Also papers which are very thin, and some papers which are looking like a scrapbooking papers. It's just the size is more A4 than a scrapbooking paper. And I was thinking for a long time, what can I do with that? And then it just occurred to me that I can do a small scrapbooking layout. So I'm doing the layout 8 by 8 inches, and it works perfectly because the size is there. You can cut it very nicely to match this size. And I'm using my trimmer from Tim Holtz. I also don't want to show out the rest of the papers I have, so you'll see me working also with the rest of the papers. Meanwhile, I am gonna be adding some vintage sepia ink to the edges of my photo and also to the edges of the paper itself. This paper I absolutely love. I love the geometrical figures again because, you know, I love them. But also the coloring and the fact that it's looking so soft and really, really beautiful. And I thought that it would match perfectly the pictures I have, but I also am gonna be using the stencil from Marta, from Maremi Small Art. And I have to say, honestly, this is my favorite stencil of hers. And I absolutely love it. For a long time, I didn't know what to use. So you're gonna see it in a few minutes. First thing first, I'm gonna use first the matte gel from PBO to apply to the page. Even though the paper is quite sturdy, I'm gonna be also working with some paints. I'm gonna be working with texture paste. So the best thing is to protect the page, and you can do it either with the gel, either matte or glossy, or with a clear gesso. So now I'm showing you a fine grain texture paste from Rico Design, one of my favorites. And this is the stunning stencil from Maremi Small Art. And the whole idea of this layout is to actually show the stencil as much as possible and also show the page as much as possible. That's why I call it minimalistic. There is not too many embellishments, and this has been done on purpose. When I'm creating, very often it happens that there are things which takes my breath away, and the connection with this paper and this beautiful stencil, it does just exactly that. I simply love it to pieces. So as I said, I'm gonna be doing as little embellishment as possible to just show it to its full beauty. And with the rest of the papers, I'm building layers. First, I use the scissors to distress the edges a little bit. I don't have a distress tool, I just use scissors. I find that they are useful and, well, they work fine for me. And I'm gluing everything together with just normal glue because it's a paper, so it doesn't bother me too much. And of course, I made a mistake because I should have done that, which means inking the edges before I glue the pieces together, but I could bend them a little and add the ink, so, well, it's not a big deal at the end of the day. And I wet the previously dried page, and I'm gonna be using Magical Cattail Copper Brown, and I put it on the side because I want exactly brown color. If I'd sprinkle it on the page, I might get some different colors, maybe a little bit of pink also, which I didn't want for this layout. So it's safer to work like that with Magical if you really want to get the color which is on the lid. And so I'm alternating between spraying some water and adding the water to the brush and adding the paint to the paper, and I'm trying to add the paint in between the lines. And you'll see also after drying, especially, it's visible that the paint stays just beside the lines. It makes this shadowing, this beautiful effect, and that I love very much also. I'm adding slightly, as you can see here, also on the stenciled part, but not that much. I want to have this really darker spaces in between the lines. I needed more contrast, so I'm using another Magical Sandra di Sepia, and I'm doing exactly the same. I'm putting it on the side, then adding it with a brush and trying to put in between the lines and make the more shadows. Now I'm gonna be adding some Blazing Black from Lindy's Gang, and I'm gonna be using technique which I remember very well from Marta herself, from Marta Łapkowska, and somehow I associate this technique really with her, and although I know other people use it, and this is basically just unscrewing the bottle and adding the paint this way, as you can see with the sprayer. So this is how the page looks like after drying. You're gonna see it in a second. It's more soft, the colors are more soft, even the black just kind of flew all over the page, and it gave the soft accents. It's not very striking, which works perfectly again with the page I have from Art Techniques. And I'm adding some stamping. So for the full list of products, there's also a link to Marta's shop. Just have a look in the description box below this video. And I'm adding this bits and pieces concentric circle stamp, which matches a little also the page, because the page has big circles on it. And now I add a little piece of cardboard to lift a little bit the picture out of the whole composition. And I will glue it in the middle, but before I'll use some fantasy dyes. I want to do a kind of a, it's not industrial really, but it's kind of a mixture maybe between a little bit vintage, a little bit industrial or a city kind of thing. This particular dye reminds me a lot the plants of Metro. So I think it will match the whole idea, even though the picture looks old and it's vintage, and well, you know, this is a place for your interpretation, the art, and I find it, you know, sometimes the things maybe not make sense if you apply logic to it, but to me there is not necessarily a logic in what I'm doing, it's just kind of the feeling I have. So I glue everything with the matte gel from PBO, but you'll see me later. I will have to add some 3D gel, because the picture, the whole composition were actually going out of the page, or ungluing, I don't think it's a good word, but you know what I mean. And at this point I'm adding some color to the edges with the vintage sepia ink. It's a great ink also, it's quite resistant to water. I wouldn't say it's fully resistant, but it is quite resistant. And I'm adding some splatter with Sandra di Sepia, trying to cover the photo, but not fully. There is some splatter which is falling on the edges of the photo, and that's really fine with me. And now I decided to add some wiring. I'll add it with the small brads. They are tiny, really. Look at my hand, it's completely dirty from the ink, but well. And I punch the holes through the paper whenever I wanted the brads to go. And I'll place my wire like that, and I hold it between the brads. So now you see me fixing my photo with 3D matte gel. The things like that happen. I was thinking the regular matte gel will do the trick, but because there is some stenciling underneath, it did not work. And I'll add some small accent with aged brass wax from Finavar. And as always, I'll do it with my hand because I really, really like the control you have over it, and also the feeling you have, so you know where the things go. So of course my layout wouldn't be finished without word stickers, and I am choosing again Maremi Small Art word stickers. I'm showing you a Sol, but actually I use the Artastic, and because the stickers are quite thin, I always place them on the piece of cardboard or cardstock paper, cut it out, and then I ink the edges, so the two layers are not that visible, and like that the sticker is most sturdy and it can go on the layout. Even though I love this layout, I still feel a little sad that so much of this stencil was covered. If I could, I'd just leave it like that, you know what, something tiny in the middle, but I think it would have no interest for you to watch, simply. And the last thing is, of course, a tiny bit of more splatter. For that I'm using watercolor, oil-soluble watercolor pastels from Prima, and they are giving this tiny splatter. So you see, guys, very easy layout, very quick, and still I find it really effective. Beautiful products from Maremi Small Art, so check out her shop. Don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell button to be notified about my upcoming videos. I wish you a lovely day, full of sun, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye!